Concept of self-development. Self-development is taking personal responsibility for one's own learning and development through a process of assessment, reflection, and action. Self-concept is developed primarily through our communication with others. Since we are social beings, we develop understanding of ourselves in terms of our relationship with other people. A number of models and explanations of the self include elements of self-perceptions, but most of them are uncertain regarding the aspects of the self that the individual holds perception of. William James was amongst the earliest theorists who described the nature of the self. According to him, the self includes a material self, a social self, and a spiritual self. In this definition, material self means a person's possessions, body and family. Social self perhaps implies how a person deals with people in his society, and spiritual self denotes how a person deals with the spiritual aspect of his life. The development of self-awareness does not occur in all or non-fiction. Thus, we cannot say that up to this point, the child does not possess it, but beyond this point, he does. Self-discovery is an ongoing process, especially in children, as children keep discovering their new potentials as they grow up. Self-discovery is an everlasting process in those people as well who keep making attempts to discover their potentials as long as they live. Next, hierarchy of self-concepts. The organization of self-concept, acquired from a wide variety of experiences, is hierarchical. Each new self-concept is integrated with those that have already been formed and influences others that are formed later. Primary or first self-concept. The quality of child's relationship with his family members plays an important role in the formation of his primary self-concept. It is shaped by a child's social experiences at home during his early years. The primary self-concept is in hierarchy is does a mirror image of social self-concept. As his social context increases, the child acquires other mirror images of himself, and these are secondary in the hierarchy of self-concept. Generally, the primary self-concept determines the selection of situations in which the secondary self-concept will be formed. For example, if at home a child has developed a primary self-concept whose dominant elements support his feeling of self-importance, he would select playmates who treat him in the similar way his family members do. Next is secondary self-concept. When the child becomes mature enough to evaluate himself in relation to others, around the age of 5 to 6 years, he starts imagining how he would like to be, and this is the beginning of ideal self-concept. The ideal self-concept is influenced by the self-concept formed earlier. A highly unrealistic ideal self-concept will increase a person's dissatisfaction with his mirror images and basic self-concept. Thus, for a happy life, all the self-concept in the hierarchy must be integrated. The integration would depend on the degree of continuity in the social and cultural environment at home and outside. Next, pattern of development. The pattern of development is quite predictable, and it can be understood as physical and psychological self-concept. Physical self-concept is usually acquired before psychological self-concept. The child has an image of his physical characteristics before he is aware of his abilities, disabilities, needs, and aspirations. Emotions also play an important role in the development of psychological self-concept. Gradually, the images of psychological and physical concepts fuse. This usually happens during late childhood. The feelings and attitudes according to self images also fuse. At puberty, an individual's attention is focused on his rapidly changing appearances. The person approaching old age likewise changes his physical self-concept. The psychological self-concept includes a person's attitude towards his abilities and disabilities, his roles in life, his responsibilities, his hopes and his aspirations. This self-concept develops after the physical self-concept. Social contacts with siblings provide the basis for an individual's first assessment of his abilities. Later, he compares himself with children outside home, and at adolescent, he compares himself with co-workers in business or workplace. Social self-concept. Early social self-concept or mirror images develop at home because a child's relationship with his mother is the first significant relationship in life. Later, the child develops social relationship with other family members, and their treatment towards him contributes to the development of his social self-concept. Lack of social relationships at home, such as presence of an unloving stepmother, lead to the development of damaging self-concept in a child. Later, outsiders' attitude, as the child interprets them, exerts a great influence on his self-concept. Similarly, the cultural stereotypes, ethnic identity, religious affiliations, social class discriminations are likely to have a great influence on a person's self-concept. Next is a basic self-concept. To develop a basic self-concept that is free from the influence of mirror images, the person must do three things. Number one, he must become psychologically independent. Number two, he must make use of his abilities to think and make decisions for himself. Number three, he must have social contacts with all kinds of people so that he can see himself as an individual distant from people he is closely connected to. Development of basic self-concept is a long and arduous task. In real sense, it never ends because the concept changes as a person's estimates of his ability change. However, it is observed that there is always resistance to change when an individual has to accept his less favorable self-concept, and when he realizes that he is not as perfect as his parents, grandparents, and other relatives have led him believe he is. Ideal self-concept. It begins around the age of 3 years and reaches its peak between 4 to 5 years. The more dissatisfied a person is with himself and the more unsatisfactory the mirror images he has developed in his relationship with others are, the stronger is his motivation to develop ideal self-concepts. If the ideal self-concept is unrealistic, it leads to dissatisfaction. The development of ideal self-concept follows a quite predictable pattern. The young child usually makes a member of the family his ideal, who he thinks is superior to others. Every individual has some ideal people in his life, either a movie star or an eminent personality. Next, dominance and stability of self-concept. In the hierarchy of self-concepts, self-concepts are not separate or distinct from one another, but are so fused and interrelated that each influences others and is influenced by others. However, it is believed that dominant self-concepts in the hierarchy will be those that give maximum satisfaction to the person. Only when the self-concept is relatively stable, a person can develop a true sense of identity. Changes in self-concept are inevitable because self-concept is composed of a person's thoughts and feelings, which are dynamic in nature. The four common kinds of variations in the stability of self-concept are: Number 1. Self-concept may fluctuate either momentarily or over a long period of time. Number two, it may occur within different self-image areas such as ideal and basic. Number three, variation may be found in different interpersonal situations. Number four, variation occurs within different self structures. The ideal self-concept may vary, but the real or basic self-concept may remain stable.